ब्रह्म विद्या संप्रदाय कर्तृभ्यो वंशेभ्यो महत्यो गुरुभ्य सर्वोपप्रवृत्त प्रज्ञान प्रत्यगर्थो मैवाहमस्मी ब्रह्मेवाहमस्मी नारायणं पद्मभूमिष्ठं शक्तिं च तत्पुत्रपराशरं च व्यासं शुकं गौड़पदं महांतं गोविंद योगींद्रमथास्य शिष्यं श्रीशंकराचार्यमथास्य पद्मपादं च हस्तामरकं च शिष्यं तन्तोटकं वार्तिककारमन्यानस्मि गुरुं समर्थमानोऽस्मि शक्तिस्मृतिपुराणानाम् आलयं करुणालयं नमामि भगवत्पादं शंकरं लोकशंकरं शंकरं शंकराचार्यं केशवं बादरायणं सूत्र भाष्यकृतौ वंदे भगवन्तौ पुनः पुनः ईश्वरो गुरुरात्मेति मूर्ति भेद विभागिने व्योमवद्व्याप्त देहाय दक्षिणामूर्तये नमः। ॐ सहनावतु सहनौ भुनक्तु सह वीर्यं करवावहै तेजस्विनावधीतमस्तु मा विद्विषावहै। ॐ शान्ति शान्ति शान्तिः। यद्ब्रह्म गोचर विचित्रतमः प्रभावात् संसार जीजनित दुःखमभूज्जनस्य यद्ब्रह्म जीजनित सौख्यमभूच्च तस्य तं रुक्मिणी सहित नमामि। यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदरापमहत्पदं तमहमाशु हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनं च सुखाकृतिम्। In the Tika, we are looking at Buddhistasya Upekshanharattvam Prasanga Sangatihi Taya Prayoga Sadhutvam Ashanke Nishedati Dacha Ityadina. So is this a Sadhu Prayoga Yushmadasmat Pratyay Gocharayohu in the Adhyasa Bhashya? That is questioned because as per Panini Sutra, when you have Pratyay or Uttar Pada following, meaning when you have a samastapada or you have a taddhita yutpatti, then the yushmat or asmat should take tva and ma. Ma pariyanta should take tva and ma adeshas respectively. Actually tvakara and makara, and thereby yushmat should become tvam and tvat. It should become, yushmat should become tvad and asmat should become mad. Like twadiyam madiyam twatputra matputra iti vat twanmat pratyegochara iti syad iti vachyam na cha vachyam. So the Siddhanti says you should not bring about this kind of an objection. Why so? Tika says, in Tika this the derivation is given, sutrena vyakrana sutrena ityartha. So pratyaya uttara padayoscha iti sutrena. What sutra is this? It is a Panini Sutra, Vyakrana Sutra in the Ashtadhyayi. So, Sutrena, Vyakrana Sutra Nityartaha. Parataha means pare. So, in Ratna Prabha, it has been said, Pratye, the meaning has been explained. The Sutra meaning has been explained as Pratyecha Uttarapadecha Parataha Yushmadasmad Yushmadasmadoho Maparyantasya Tamadesha Ustaha Iti vidhanat. So what is that? Parataha. Parata means pare. When pratyaya or uttarapada follow. Pratyaye saptami is parasaptami. Uttarapade is a parasaptami. So that is pare. When pratyaya or uttarapada follows. So pare sati ityartha. It's a sati saptami. But parasaptami, also called as parasaptami in Vyakarana. युष्मत् शब्दस्य यन् म पर्यन्तम् तस्य त्व इत्यादेशः यस्मत् शब्दस्य अस्मत् शब्दस्य यन् म पर्यन्तस्य यन् म पर्यन्तम् तस्य म इत्यादेशः प्राप्नोति इति भावः। सो द डिविजन इज एक्सप्लेन्ड एज युष्मत् टिल मकार इन द युष्मत् इज रिप्लेस्ड बाय त्व एंड इन अस्मत् Up till Makara is replaced by Makara itself. Sautra Saptami Dvivachanat Sautra Saptami Dvivachananta Padam Pruthag Anvayatvena Vyakhyaya Kramena Pruthag Udharan Darshayati Tvadiyam Iti. And these examples are given separating Yushmat and Asmat also pratyaya and uttarapada. So yushmat with a pratyaya, asmat with a pratyaya, then yushmat with uttarapada and asmat with uttarapada. That has been explained as twadiyam, madiyam, tvatputra and matputra. Four examples have been given. The earlier two are yushmat and asmat respectively with taddita derivation, and the latter two are the yushmat and asmat respectively with the samastapada, uttarapada. Tava idam twadiyam, tika tava idam twadiyam. So this is yours. How do you say that? Yushmat plus idam. So tava idam twadiyam. What is that? Dhanam iti sheshaha. So what is yours? So something has to be qualified there. So that is dhanam. The substantive can be taken as dhanam, and twadiyam will become an adjective to that. So when you have to talk about something that is yours, what is that something? So to explain, dhanam has been added. Your dhana, your wealth. How do you say it? Twadiyam dhanam. Iti sheshaha twadiyam ityudharane pratye paratvam asti pratyastu cha pratya chasya iyadeshaha. So there is a sutra which replaces cha. Cha is a pratya which is added. So yushmat plus cha, and then cha will be replaced by iya, and then you will get yushmat plus iya. Iti adesha prapnuti tatha cha yushmat iya iti sthite ma paryantasya tva ityadeshe prapte. So actually it is sakara and vakara. So tva ityadesha, it has been said tva, but then takara vakara, or if you take tva, then it is not ma paryanta, a will also be replaced. But then yushma ma paryanta has been mentioned, so a will remain on the yushmat side, and takara vakara will be the single replacement there. So yushmat plus iya will become twat plus iya. Thereby tva ityadeshe prapte shatruvad adesha ityavi abhyukta vyavaharena varnadesha varna adarshana prapte twat iya iti sthite supratyaya vidhanantaram. Because the derivation, when you explain the derivation, the vyakaranas do not consider the word which is the resultant, not an undeclined word in the prakriyavastha. When the pratyaya is added, whichever sutra you are dealing with, whatever is the resultant of that sutra, one shouldn't stop there. It is not considered as sadhu prayoga because it is not a padam. Suptingantam padam, only a pada should be used in a sentence. Therefore, in kashikadi vrittis, you will not find halfway derivations. You will not find derivations, in fact. Derivations are the job of the tikas on kashika, etc. But you will see the word which is with the supratya will be shown. A subanta pada will be shown, or a tinganta pada will be shown as an example. Or in the example sections, you will find only the derived words, the end resultant pada. So you have to find out as to what was the result of the sutra proper that you are dealing with. In that udaharana, in that pada, which step exactly was the resultant of the current sutra. So here what has been done is, the same idea has been explained as to what happens then. Once iya adesha is given, this yushmat is replaced by tva, then shatruvat adesha, it's an adesha, it is not an agama, so adesha will completely replace the sthani. Whatever has to be replaced will be completely replaced. So it's a substitute which will, it's a vidhi which ordains a replacement, not an augment or an augmentation or an addition. So he's contrasting the agama with the adesha. So shatruvad adesha ityabhi abhyukta vyavaharena varnadarshana prapte tvatiya iti sthite supratya vidhanantaram saha ucharanam. Obviously you cannot pause in the prakriyavastha, so the pada has to be completely pronounced. You should not pause in between. Therefore what will you get? Putra padasya uttara padatvam, sorry, twadiyam in the saha ucharanam, twadiyam iti rupa nishpattihi. So you get the rupa nishpatti, the form is twadiyam when it is declined. Here also you should get a similar adesha, and yushmat should be replaced. Yushmat should sound like twat in the samasa. That is the objection. एंड सिमिलरली वेन यू एक्सटेंडेड टू अदर्स एवं मदीयम इत्यत्र अस्मत्पुत्र इति स्थिते पुत्र पदस पुत्र पदस्य उत्तर पदत्वं परत्वं च विज्ञेयम् सो दि उत्तर पद इज पुत्र हियर इन दि अस्मत्पुत्र युष्मत् दि अस्मत्पुत्र वेर यू शुड बिकम मत्पुत्र एंड युष्मत्पुत्र वी शुड बिकम त्वत्पुत्र तथा च सॉरी तथा च युष्मद् अस्मद् इत्यादि भाष्ये उत्तरपदस्य परत्वसत्वात् त्वन्मत् प्रत्यय गोचरयोरिति स्यादिति भावः सिंस भगवान भाष्यकार हैज मेड अ समस्त पद इन द्विवचन युष्मद् अस्मद् प्रत्यय गोचरयोः सो इट्स अ द्विवचन एंड इट्स अ समस्त पद देयरफॉर देयर इज एन उत्तर पद Following Yushmat as well as Asmat. In which case, there should have been a replacement as the Sutra ordains, Vyakarana Sutra. So, Tathacha, Yushmat Asmat Ityadi Bhashya Uttarapadasya Paratvasatvat Tvanmat Pratyay Gocharayor Iti Syaditi Bhavaha. So, the objection is that, why did Bhagavan Bhashyakara say Yushmat Asmat Pratyay Gocharayoho? It should have been Tvanmat Pratyay Gocharayoho. So the reason this is questioned, one is Asadhu Prayoga by the Puro Pakshi's angle. When the Siddhanti is questioning, then is there something more? Is there something more as to why Bhagavan Bhashyakara chose not to make it Tvat and Mat Tvat Mat Pratyay Gocharayoho? Even if there was there a pravritti of that sutra, was that sutra prapta one? If it was prapta, why it was not applied? So what is an additional benefit you get by not applying the sutra? Or in which case the sutra is not applied so that you get a particular meaning? And what is that particular meaning? So these are the questions based on which this grammatical point has come up. It is not just, you know, oh, it's not a sadhu prayoga and all that. So, Purvapakshi's drishti is fine. But we as Siddhanti should see as to is there something more. And that something more is being shown. Tvamaviti. Ratna Prabha. Tvamaveka vachane ityeka vachanadhikarat atra cha yushmadasmat pratyaya yushmadasmat padayoho ekartha vachitva bhavat anatmanam yushmadarthanam bhutvad asmadartha चैतन्यस्य अपि उपायतो भूत्वात् सो इति न वाच्यम् वाच्यम् किन्न वाच्यम् यू शुड नॉट से दैट द सूत्र प्रत्ययोत्तर पदयोश्च शुड हैव अप्लाइड एंड द युष्मदस्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरयोः वर्ड शुड हैव बीन त्वन्मत् प्रत्ययगोचरयोः इति स्याद् इति न वाच्यम् व्हाई शुडंट द पूर्वपक्षी से दैट व्हाई शुडंट ही रेज सच एन ऑब्जेक्शन दिस इज द आंसर तमावेक वचने दी तो एंड म सो तमौ तमौ एक वचने दिस आदेश तो एंड म फॉर युष्मत एंड अस्मद रिस्पेक्टिवली आर टू बी अप्लाइड ओनली इन एक वचन एक वचने तमौ भवतः स्तः स्याताम दिस इज द आदेश रिस्पेक्टिवली These two are the adeshas only in ekavachana. Then what does it mean? If it has not been applied, if the form is not tvanmat pratyay gocharayo and instead the form has been retained as yushmat asmat pratyay gocharayo, then it means that it is not dealing with ekavachana. It is dealing with more than ekavachana. So what is it? There is bahuvachana. How so? Iti ekavachana adhikarat atracha. In this case, what has happened? Yushmat. When you say Yushmat has been established as what? It has been claimed, not established, claimed as Idam, the Anatma. And Asmat has been claimed as Shuddha Chaitanya Atma. Although for Anatma, you should not have used Yushmat, but you should have used Idam. This is an objection which has been raised. The conclusion I have already mentioned. To show the contrast and idam can also be misunderstood with aham as these are us so we are these that kind of usage is there in Sanskritam also ime vayam. So that usage can be there. Therefore, yushmat is used to contrast with asmat, and viruddha swabhava is clear there. But yushmat being retained instead of twad and asmat being retained instead of mad shows you that there is non-ekavachana. And here in this case, bahuvachana. How can there be bahuvachana? Anatma is bahu, therefore bahuvachana pluralistic. Although we say dvaita, anatma is all plural. Therefore, yushmat is very clear as anatma being bahuvachana. What about asmat? Asmat is single atma, you are nadvaitin. Even if you say every anatma is mithya, and each jiva gata, jiva upadhi gata, antakarana anatma upadhi gata, atma is one. Even if you count many anatma, shariras, antakaranas, ahankaras, but still the ahankara gata jiva should be one. That is atma finally, brahmatma, that you claim to be one. If that is the case, then how can there be bahuvachana there? That is the question there. So atra cha yushmad asmat padayoho ekartha vachitva bhava. There is no ekartha vachana there. Therefore, what anatmanam yushmadarthanam bahutvat. Therefore, yushmat has not been replaced by tva because yushmadartha is anatma. And anatmas being many bahutvat. Also asmadartha. Asmadartha is chaitanya. So asmadartha chaitanya syapi upaditaha bahutvat. How can there be bahutvam in asmadartha atma? Chaitanya, Shuddha Chaitanya. That is also counted to be many under the influence of Upadhi. So, Upadhi Taha, Upadhi Vashat. That is the idea here. Therefore, Ma Adesha has also not been applied to Asmat. Tika. Yada Yushmad Asmat Padayoho Pratyekam Ekarthavachitvam Tada Pratyecha Uttarapadecha Paresati मपर्यन्तस्य त्वमाव इत्यादेशौ स्तः इति व्याकरण सूत्रस्य अर्थः. सो दैट सूत्रा हैज नॉट बीन कंप्लीटली एनालाइज्ड बाय यू सेज द सिद्धांति. इट अप्लाइज ओनली इन द केस ऑफ एकवचन. हियर देयर इज नो एप्लीकेशन ऑफ एकवचन. ननु युष्मदर्थस्य बहुत्वेपि प्रत्यगात्मनः ननु युष्मदर्थस्य बहुत्वेपि प्रत्यगात्मनः एकत्वेन अस्मदर्थैकत्वात् अस्मत्पदस्य मपर्यन्तस्य म इत्यादेशस्यादित्यतः अस्मदर्थ इति. सो चैतन्य कैनॉट बी मेनी वॉज द ऑब्जेक्शन. सो अस्मत् शुड हैव टेकन म पर्यन्त म आदेश. एटलीस्ट दैट शुड हैव हैपेंड. सो दैट हैज बीन रिफ्यूटेड. वी सॉ इन दी रत्नप्रभा एज टू उपादितः भूत्वात् ननु अस्मत् शब्द पूर्वं प्रयोक्तव्यः. नाउ देयर इज अ डिफरेंट ऑब्जेक्शन. Asmat Shabda should have been used earlier, not Yushmat Shabda. So it should have been at least Asmad Yushmad Pratyay Gocharayo. Why not do that? What is the Pramana for Asmat to have been before as per the Purva Pakshi? So Nanu Asmat Shabda Purvam Prayoktavya Ekasheshascha Syaditi Praptam Dushanadvayam Kimiti Naudghatya Parihrutam Iti Chenna. Now there is an objection which is going to come up. Why has it not been raised now? This is the question. So the Purva Paksha as to why is the Purva Paksha not raised here? And what is that Purva Paksha? We will see later. One is why shouldn't Asmat be used earlier? And why shouldn't Asmat being used earlier? What will happen? We will see. See, basically when we say you and I, Yushmat and Asmat is you and I. In English, what do we say? We don't say you and I all the time. Generally, we compound it together and we say we both. So, you is opposite to I. Opposite in a sense, at least viruddhatvam is there. You is not I, I is not you. But when we say we both together, we want to talk about something, a kriya, let's say, let us both go. Let us both go. We both. So, we is what? We is Uttama Purusha usage. Even in English, it's first person. When you say you two, you all, they both, they all, then that is the usage. We don't say we in the case of third person. We don't say we in the case of second person also. We say we when there is more than one, meaning plural in English. And if you want to compare it, then for two or more, we use we in first person. And that includes the Yushmat also, meaning it means includes you also. Very strange. Very strange in the sense, that's how the language is. Sanskrit also, English also. Now when you say we both, there where, how do you know what is this we both? The you is already hidden in we. So in Sanskritam also, there should be a replacement. What is that? Ekasheshaha. So just like another example, when you say Yushmat and Asmat, similarly, what is well known is Ramaha and Rama, Balaka and Balaka. So Balaka and Balaka, Rama and Lakshmana would be Rama Lakshmanau. Rama and Rama would be Rama Ramau, should have been Rama Ramau. What happens? Ekasheshaha. Rama Ramau becomes Ramau. Rama Rama Ramaha becomes Rama Ramaha. Then it becomes, sorry, Rama Ramau or Ekashesha. Directly also you can say Ramaha. So the way Rama Lakshmanau but Ramau Balakau, Rama Lakshmana Bharataha but Ramaha Ekashesha. Even if there are many, it drops to one. Where the Dvivachana or Bahuvachana Pratyaya is maintained. However, the Anga which is there, the Prakriti, that will show you only one. Now similarly, when Yushmat Asmat also come together, like we say, we both in English, here also what should have happened? It should have been Avam. In the case we both, how do you say in Sanskritam? We say Aham. Avam Vayam. So that Vam Adesha should have taken place. That has not taken place, and this objection has not been raised. You have raised only one objection, why not raise that also? So there the Tikakara says it is going to come up when the Ratna Prabhakara will talk about Ashrama Shri Charanaha. So we'll talk about one Acharya from the Ashrama who gives a solution to this. So that is going to come up, therefore it is not raised here. Ashrama Shri Charana Matanirupane Asya Dushana Dvayasya Parihrishya Manatvad Atra Udghatya Na Parihritam Iti Bhavaha. It has not been raised in this context now, but it is going to come up and the solution will be given by Ratna Prabha a little later. So this objection will be raised. So let's move on. Evam Swamatanu Sarana. So Siddhanti says, let's move on. We'll raise this objection and answer that also. Evam Swamatanu Sarana Prayogam Sadayitva. Now, when he says in Sanskritam also, when you say Lopa Shakalyasya, then Panini Maharshi, when he brings another Vayakarana Acharya, Purvacharya, to explain a rule, that means he may or may not agree. There is no conviction as to he agrees. He says some, and it is also to show respect that this rule was there earlier also. I am not forming the rule. I am not interpreting or deciphering the rule. This rule was there. It was shown by a Purvacharya. That is one respect. The other is to show that he says is I may or may not agree. Meaning, or there are other opinions also. Therefore, a vibhasha is created. So, lopa shakalasya is an optional lopa. You can have lopa, you may not have lopa. So, you can have asav aditya or you can have asav aditya. So, if you don't do sandhi, asav aditya. But if you, once the sandhi is applied, which is H-O-A-H-O-A-Y-O-R. So that sandhi, once it is applied, ayadi sandhi, then you will get asav aditya. Vakar will be heard. Asav aditya. If you apply lopa shakalasya, yakara vakara would undergo lopa. Bho vago vago apurvasya yoshi. And then lopa shakalasya. Now this is a vibhasha. Just by saying lopa shakalasya matena, thereby a vibhasha is created. So if you apply the lopa shakalasya sutra, then you will get vakara lopa. And since it's a vibhasha, optionally applied, if you don't apply, then you will get this vakara will remain. Otherwise, vakara will go away. So you will get asavaditya, asavadityaha, or you will get asaadityaha. Both are valid forms, asavadityaha and asaaditya. Similarly, here what has been done, the parishkara which is given is in multiple ways, more than one way. So that question which is not being raised here, because there is an explanation which is being followed as per a particular matha. As per Ashrama Shri Charana, that matha will come up later. Thereby, it is mentioned, even swamatanusarena. As per Ratna Prabhakara's interpretation, a parihara is given. So, even swamatanusarena prayogam sadayitva, swamatanusari vyakhyanam sputi kartum shankam avatareti. Now, to clarify his solution further, he raises a doubt. So that the flow isn't lost, he is not taking the other objections right now. Those objections will come up later and a parihara will be given as per another matha in the Siddhanta itself. So, nanu evam satiti. Ratna Prabha. So, nanu evam sati. So nanu evam sati katam atra bhashye vigraha. Now if you say there are more yushmats and more asmats, meaning bahuvachana in both cases, then how will the vigraha work? The samasa should have vigraha. What is the vigraha in this case? Tika virodham sadayati iti pratijnyaya bahutvangikare sati ityartha. So what is this virodha here? Yushmat and asmat have virodha. And you are claiming yushmat is bahuvachana, asmat is also bahuvachana. Iti pratinya bahutvangikare satityartha. If you accept bahuvachana on both sides, then what happens is that I'll have to question the vigraha. Samasadi rupa urtyartha pratipadakam vakyam vigraha. What is a vigraha? Vigraha is the explanation of the compound. That is a vigraha vakya. So what is that? And the solution is questioned. If at all you say this is the vigraha, then I question it, says the Pura Pakshi. Nacha yuyam iti pratyaya yushmat pratyaya vayam iti pratyaya asmat pratyaya tad gocharayo iti vigraha iti vachyam. And you can't give a solution, says the Pura Pakshi, to the Siddhanti as to yuyam iti pratyaya yushmat pratyaya. What is this UM Vidhi Pratyaya Yushmat Pratyaya Karmadharaya? Between UM, Yushmat and Pratyaya, there is a Karmadharaya. If you say that, and then you say Vayam Iti Pratyaya Asmat Pratyaya UM, Vayam. This is all Bahuvachana. So UM is you all, Vayam is we all. What is this you all? All these, basically all these Anatmas. All these Anatmas, that kind of Pratyaya is what? Is Yushmat Pratyaha. And all of us, that kind of a Pratyaya is what? All of us, that is a Pratyaya, that is an understanding. That's a Vritti. So when I say all of us, that itself is a Vritti. That itself is a Pratyaya. It's a Pratiti. we'll see there is a virodha there also at all three levels with a particular samasa vigraha. So vayam iti pratyaya asmat pratyaha. This kind of a samasa vigraha if you give, then what will happen? And then further what? You have two pratyas now. You have yum pratyaya and you have yum iti pratyaya and you have vayam iti pratyaya. So these all and we all. This kind of two types of understandings are there now. I'm just loosely, I'll not translate it because the translation varies based on the derivation of pratyaya, where the virodha is there. So, but the Purvapakshi does not know that. So Purvapakshi says that if this is a pratyaya, these all anatmas, and on the other hand, you are showing the virodha with what? We all. This kind of an understanding, this kind of a pratyaya is there. You put both of them together into this gochara word following. How do you put it? How do you connect it? He says, tad gocharayoho. Then these two pratyas, if you put together and you say tad gocharayoho iti vigraha iti navachyam, you should not say that. Why? Shabda sadhutvapi arthas asadhutvat. The derivation wise, technically it is all right, but then there is no meaning to this. What kind of meaning is this? As to these all anatmas, we all atmas, and then gocharayoho, tad gocharayoho. So they won't connect into gochara properly with this bahuvachana. What kind of vigraha vakya is this? So derivation wise it may look proper, but then just because it is technically right does not mean it has any meaning. So there won't be any proper meaning there. So shabda sadhutvapi artha sadhutvat. Tika. Nacha yuyam iti pratyaha yushmat pratyaha vayam iti pratyaha asmat pratyaha tad gocharyo iti vigraha iti vachyam. There the tika says virodha yushmat shabdolikha mana pratyaha yushmat pratyaha ityartha. So what is this yushmat iti? So yushmat shabdolikhya mana pratyaha yushmat pratyaha. What appears to be the meaning of this shabda, yushmat shabda, that is shabdolikhya, and that is the pratyaya. Therefore karmadhara yushmat shabdolikhya mana pratyaya yushmat pratyaya ityartha yuyam iti pratyaya yushmat pratyaya vayam iti pratyaya asmat pratyaya iti vruddha vyavaharanusaryol sari alaukiko vayam vigraha laukikaha tu asadhu. So what is this? This is an alaukika vigraha, not laukika vigraha. Why laukika? What has been said here? This is laukika vigraha. Yoyam iti pratyaya, yushmat pratyaya, vayam iti pratyaya, asmat pratyaya, tad gocharayoho. So this is a laukika vigraha, which anyone can understand if they know Sanskrita. They don't need to understand Vyakrana Sutras. So the, since he this meaning which has been given in the Laukika Vigraha, that meaning is not straightforward. Nobody can understand it. It seems as if there is no meaning to this. It is just technical derivation. There is no meaning to it. Therefore, it cannot be Laukika Vigraha. So what should it be? It should be Alaukika Vigraha. Alaukika Vigraha, the meaning of Alaukika Vigraha is what? It is the Suaujas, Amautsas, Tabhyambhis, those kind of pratyas. So the 21 supratyas, these should be added to both padas in whatever meaning it is there in the samasa, whatever cases are there in the samasas, those particular pratyas, whether ek vachana, dvivachana or bahuvachana, those should be added. Here you say bahuvachana, so yushmat plus bahuvachana pratyaya should be there, and then pratyaya with a ekavachana pratyaya should be there. So pratyaya is a word which will take an ekavachana pratyaya, and then you put them together, then that will be an alaukika vigraha. Is that what you are saying then? If it is not a laukika vigraha, it should be an alaukika vigraha. So that is mentioned here as to iti vruddha vyavaharanusari alaukikoyam vigraha laukikaha tu asadhu. Laukika is asadhu. Because there is no meaning to Laukika Vigraha as explained in Ratna Prabha what is given in Ratna Prabha as an objection. Yadi yushmatcha asmatcha yushmad asmadi tayo pratyaha yushmat pratyaha asmat pratyascha iti laukika vigraha eva syad ityuchyeta tada yushmad asmat padayor bhavartvachitva pakshe yushmatcha asmatcha iti vigraha eva anupapannasyat tayoho ekarthvachitvabhavat tasmad alaukikoyam vigraha. So there is a technical objection here now. Because meaning isn't there, then you have to bring about an alaukika vigraha. So if you say, this is what? Yushmatcha asmatcha yushmad asmadi. You bring the yushmat and asmat together and then make a dvandva there. Yushmad asmadi. And tayoho pratyaya you make a shashti after that. So you will get yushmat pratyaya asmat pratyayascha iti. Then this pratyaya and pratyaya will drop off, one will remain like a mathematical equation and you will get yusmat asmat pratyaya. Is that how you will create it? That is a laukika vigraha. If you say laukika vigraha eva syaditi uccheta, if you were to say that, then what will happen? Tada yusmat asmat padayoho bauhartha vachitva pakshe yusmatcha asmatcha iti vigraha eva anupapanna syat. Then you won't get yushmatcha asmatcha iti vigraha. That vigraha is not possible. Because you have got yushmat pratyaya, asmat pratyaya and there is a bahu vachana. So they can't go in this kind of a samasa. So let's set aside as to why a technicality is there. So there is no meaning. This bahu vachana meaning is not coming in the way the samasta pada exists in the bhashya. This is the objection. Therefore, you have to bring about an alaukika vigraha. Okay, alaukika vigraha, if it is there, then is it this pratyaya, the pratipadika plus pratyaya plus another pratipadika plus pratyaya, in whichever case and number, each of these pratyas, and then when they go in a compound, then there will be pratyaya lopa, and then you will get a compound. Then you will add another supratyaya and decline that compound itself. Is this how it has to be? Is this a solution then? That is question. Then what happens? He says, tayoho ekartha vachitva bhavat tasmad alaukiko ayam vigraha nanu vigraha dvividha. So now he says, what is laukika and alaukika? Nanu vigraha dvividha laukika alaukika shchaiti alaukikatvam. I have some trouble here with the word. There is some typo here. So alaukikatvam arupa nishtatvam, maybe, I am not sure, rupadi nishpatyartham prayuktatvam iti yavata. So there this upari nishtatvam does not, upari nishtatvam, rupari nishtatvam does not make any sense there, arupari nishtitvam. So I am not sure what this word is, but the idea seems to be, talking about the laukika and contrasting it with the alaukika vigraha. So we'll see broadly what it means, because this word particularly, there are more than one typo here as I can see. So the explanation is given anyway. Let's get the idea what is laukika, what is alaukika. We have seen this. Tikakara is mentioning details as to what pratyaya will go in. So nanu vigraha divisa laukika alaukika alaukikaha chaiti. Alaukikatvam arupa nishtatvam rupadi nishpatyartham prayuktatvam iti yavat. So alaukika is what? Alaukika is which is not seen in the rupa. That is the broad idea of that word there. Whatever that word is, what should it mean? It should mean that finally in the alaukika vigraha, whatever goes in, that is not seen in the rupa siddhi, in the loka. So laukika vigraha which is there, in the understanding, whatever is there, when you put together the samasta pada, that meaning is going to exist. The rupa is seen there. Whereas in the alaukika vigraha, there are pratyas which are technically added to derive, to apply vyakarana sutras and then get some derivation, which will go out in the loka and which will be uttered as a padam and then rupa siddhi, whatever is rupa siddha, that rupa would be heard, which will be in prayoga in the loka. They do not know how, what all has gone in. Like, by taste you know when you eat your food as to whatever ingredients have gone in. But usually you don't see everything, how much quantity, what has gone in, you don't know all that. You just know that in its entirety what the food is on your plate. The cook knows. So whoever has cooked in the kitchen, they know what has gone in. So that is a technicality there which you don't see in the food. Similarly, here in Vyakarana Sutras, whatever has been added and removed, it letters are there, pratyas are there, they are created, reverse engineered word has brought about these sutras which are applied, and then the word is re-engineered, which goes out in the loka. So laukika vigraha does not have all these alaukika rupas. They are not seen, so unseen. That is mentioned here, rupadi nishpatyartham prayuktatvam iti yavat. Iti yavat, what is that? Alaukika vigraha. Alaukika vigraha has something which is not seen in the laukika vigraha. It is not seen in the loka, in the uccharana. Tata hi raja purusha ityatra rajnyav purusha iti laukiko ayam vigraha. So example, stock example is taken, raja purushaha. When you see that samasa, what does the connection there? So those who have studied Sanskrita without Vyakrana Sutras also, they know what? Rajnyah Purusha, Raja Purusha. So Shashti Sambandha is there. It's a Shashti Tatpurusha Samasa. So Rajnyah is Shashti Ekvachana. Now in the Alaukika Vigraha, it would be Rajnyah Purusha. What will it be? It will be Rajan Shabda plus Nyas Pratya, which is actually Nyasi. So you will have Nyas, Nyas in Shashti Ekvachana. So yeah. So Rajan plus Nyas, then Purusha plus Su. Su is the Prathama Ekvachana. Nyas is the Shashti Ekvachana. So this is in the Alaukika Vigraha. Nobody sees this Rajan, Nyas, Purusha, Su in the Loka. Nobody sees this. Nobody utters this also. In Vyakarana also, this is not uttered. Asadhutvam. So uttered in the sense, while teaching it is uttered, but then you don't pause here. Rajan, Nyas, Purusha. You can't pause anywhere. It is a complete derivation, and the Rupa Siddhi takes place. As a Suptingantam Padam, either a Subanta Pada or Tingantam Pada, then that is the Sadhu Prayoga. None of these are seen in the world. So Rajan Nyas Purusha Su Iti Alaukikoyam Vigraha Tatacha Yuyam Pratyayati Katham Alaukika Vigraha Tasya Yuyam Iti Siddha Rupa Bodhakatvena Rupa Nishpatyartham Prayukta Vakyatva Bhavaditi Chena. So what is the, so if there is some confusion, I'll clarify it. If you say Bahuvachana is there, then the meaning is not seen in the Vigraha. Even if you say it is a Sadhu Prayoga, Vigraha Vakya, if you say it is Sadhu, technically, but still the meaning is not clear. Meaning is not possible, it is meaningless. Therefore, it is not a Laukika Vigraha. This is the answer from the Siddhanti. Oh, it is not a Laukika Vigraha. If you don't see it, if you say it is, it may be correct, but then it is meaningless. Then you are not seeing the meaning. Why? Because it is not a Laukika Vigraha. Oh, okay, then is it an Alaukika Vigraha? If it is Alaukika Vigraha, then Siddhanti has said it is an Alaukika Vigraha. Then this Purvapakshi says if it is an Alaukika Vigraha is not in this manner. You don't say in Alaukika Vigraha, you should see something which is not seen in the world. You should see Pratyas. We don't see any Pratyas here. Yushmat Pratya. You don't, Pratyaya word is there, that is not the Pratyaya. The Pratyaya word will take a Pratyaya. Means suffix. Pratyaya here is not in the sense of suffix. So Yushmat Pratyaya is the cognition of Yushmat. I'll just loosely translate it right now. So understanding of Anatma, understanding of Atma, Yushmat Pratyaya and Asmat Pratyaya respectively. There are two words in each of these samasas. Yushmat Pratyaya is one word where there are one compound, where two words are compounded. In which meaning, which relation are they compounded? That relation will go in a suffix. Will go as a suffix in an Alaukika Vigraha. So you should have Yushmat plus say X and Pratyaya plus Y. That X and Y are these suffixes should be seen in an Alaukika Vigraha. How do you claim this is an Alaukika Vigraha? There the Siddhanti answers as to see Alaukika Vigraha is not a technical usage here. When I say Alaukika Vigraha, all I mean with that nanj is that it is not a Alaukika Vigraha. It is a Bhinna. So I want to say this nanj is in the Bhinnartha. So Laukika Bhinnartha is there. Laukika Vigraha Bhinna Vigraha Asti. Iti evam. This is all I meant to say, says the Siddhanti. So don't jump to conclusions. So all the Tikakara is analyzing here is not what I meant, says the Siddhanti. When I say Alaukika, I just said Laukika Vigraha Bhinnaha Alaukika Vigraha. Natu राजन प्लस न्यस प्लस पुरुष प्लस सु इत्यादि होते। आई डिडंट मीन दैट, सो विल स्किप दिस, विल जस्ट गो थ्रू इट एज टू दिस इज नॉट नॉट द इंटेंशन एट ऑल। सो लौकिक विग्रह भिन्नम वाक्यांतरम एव अत्र अलौकिक विग्रह इति विवक्षितत्वात् अलौकिकः तु एवं साधनीय। देन व्हाट इज दिस अलौकिकत्वम्? अलौकिकत्वम् इज नॉट हैविंग व्याकरण प्रत्ययस्, स्वादी प्रत्ययस् आर नॉट विच आर मेंट, बट व्हाट आर मेंट देन? आई मीन व्हाट एवर लौकिक अर्थ यू सी, व्हाट इज द लौकिक अर्थ? दिस इज द वाच्यार्थ विच इज देयर इज व्हाट व्हेन यू से युष्मत्, युष्मत हैज बीन सेट टू बी अनात्मा। लेट्स से युष्मत इज टेकन लिटरली ऑल्सो व्हेन यू से यू, एंड इफ यू से अनात्मा प्रपंचा दैट, देन व्हाट डज द सिद्धांती मीन? द सिद्धांती मीन्स घटा, लेट्स से घटापटादि अनात्मा, और अनदर पर्सन यू हु हैज अ शरीर, हैज एन अंतकरण, बट ऑल दीज आर हैविंग चैतन्य ऑल्सो। In the, when I am talking to you as a person, then you are a chetana vastu, chetana padartha. There is achetana also along with it, which is what I mean by yushmat. So yushmat is a conglomerate. When I say yushmat, it means you, the sharira, with the antakkarana, with the gender, the son of this person or the daughter of that person, with playing this role, my boss, my student, my colleague, friend, whatever, but along with the Chaitanya. It's not only Chaitanya, it is not only Shariradi, Ahankaradi Shariram. Then what is it? It is a mix up of both. So that is the Vachyartha when I say Yushmat, or I say you all, you yam. And this is actually standing for anatma, so it will include my antakarana also, and it will extend to the third person also as to ghatapatadi prapancha, which although jada, just like the sharira is jada, ahankaradi sharira is jada, similarly the prapancha ghatapatadi is also jada. In fact, ahankaradi sharira is part of prapancha bhautikatvat. However, even in the ghatapatadi prapancha chaitanya is there, it is not manifest into the ghatapatadi as pratibimba. There is no pratiphalana of chaitanya which is there in the antakkarana, in my antakkarana and your antakkarana, but pratiphalita chaitanya isn't there in the ghatapatadi. Why? Because there is no antakkarana to manifest, to bring about avirbhava of Chaitanya. But Chaitanya isn't there is not agreeable to any Siddhanti, because we say Chaitanya is all pervasive, vibhutvat ekameva advityam, we say, in which case that bhuma Chaitanya is there in the yushmat pratyaya also. And when I say yushmat pratyaya, then it means the cognition of the Chaitanya and the mix-up of the antakkaranadi, ahankaradi, prapancha. Similarly, in the asmat pratyaya, what is the vachyartha? Meaning laukika artha, what is laukika vigraha? There, yushmat. When I say yushmat, the meaning will be including Chaitanya and achetana. Similarly, in the asmat pratyaya, when I say I, the very manifestation of aham is a vritti where I become a pramata, ज्ञात कर्ता भोक्ता समथिंग, देर चैतन्य अलोन इजंट देर। सो यू आर सेइंग आत्मा, अस्मत मीन्स आत्मा, बट आत्मा अलोन इजंट देर, चैतन्य अलोन इजंट देर, शुद्ध चैतन्य अलोंग विथ व्हाट? अंतकरण अहंकार आदि शरीर इज देर इवन इन दी अस्मत प्रत्यय। देर बाय युष्मत प्रत्यय मीन्स यू विद दी शरीर एंड चैतन्य, और that prapancha with the sharira and chaitanya, that is the laukika vigraha meaning and laukika artha also, laukika vigraha artha. And asmat pratyaya means shuddha chaitanya which is intended, but then Shuddha Chaitanya with the Sharira Traya is here as well, Anatma. So Atma Anatma mix up in the Yushmat Pratyah, Atma Anatma mix up in the Asmat Pratyah also. This is the Laukika Vigraha. They have different meanings. Why? Because the Upadhi is different. In Yushmat the Upadhi is different. In Asmat the Upadhi is different. The Bhautika, both may be Bhautika, but there is a difference between one Ghata and the other Ghata. Ghata and Pata, similarly between you and I, there is a difference in Antakkarana. Between Ghatapatadi and me, there is a difference in the Ghata Sharira and my Sharira. Although Ghata is not called as a Sharira because it is not Bhogayatanam, it is not a Bhogasadhana also. Does not have Antakkarana. But whatever is the boundary of the Ghata, that we will call as Sharira. If we call that as Sharira, then the Ghata Sharira is Bhinna from Mama Sharira. Therefore, there is a difference. However, both have two components. That is the Laukika Artha. So here Alaukika is Laukika Bhinna. What is this Alaukikatvam? Alaukikatvam is not the Pratyaya, technically what is called as Alaukika Vigraha in the Samasa, but Laukika Artha Bhinna. Laukika Vigraha Bhinna. And that means the Laukika Alaukika Artha. Laukika we have seen in both cases. Alaukika Artha of Yushmat is not Chaitanya and the Anatma put together, but only the Anatma. So although the Laukika Vigraha in Yushmat has Anatma component, that is not the intention there. Therefore, the meaning is Alaukika, and that Alaukikatvam in Yushmat Pratyaya is only the Anatma. That is the implied meaning, that is the Lakshana also you can say, but here it is Alaukika. That is the meaning here. Laukika Bhinna, meaning not the Chaitanya and Anatma together, but only Anatma. Similarly, what is the Laukika Bhinnatva in Asmat Pratyaya? Asmat Pratyaya also has both components, but I intend, says Bhagavan Bhashyakara, or Siddhanti says that Bhagavan Bhashyakara intends only Atma there, only Chaitanya. Although both are there, with Asmat Pratyaya, only Chaitanya is being meant. Only Atma, therefore it is Laukika Vigraha Bhinna Alaukika Vigraha. That is mentioned here as to Lakshana. Laukika Vigraha Bhinnam Vakyantaram Evatra Laukika Alaukika Vigraha Iti Vivakshitatvat Alaukika Hatu Evam Sadhaniya. How should you establish Alaukikatvam? Not with Pratyas, but what? Tatahi Yushmat Shabdasya Yushmat Shabdolikhini Lakshana Asmat Shabdasya Asmat Shabdolekhini Lakshana Tathacha Yushmat Shabdolekhich Asmat Shabdolekhich Yushmat Shabdolekhyasmat Shabdolekhinyau Lekhinau. Should have been Lekhinyau. Lekhini is there. I think there's a typo here also. Lekhinyau Nadivat. So Yushmat Shabdolekhya Yushmat Shabda Ullekhi Asmat Shabdolekhinyau Pratyascha Pratyascha Pratyayau Ullekhinau. I think it should be Ullekhinyau Ullekhin, but then maybe there is a pullinga also there. Ullekhina, maybe it is there, but since Ullekhini is mentioned, I think this should be Ullekhinyau. Chatau Pratyau cha Tayoho Gocharau cha Tayoho iti Vigraha Drashtavya. So it is a Karmadharya. What is being done is, finally he is saying it is a Karmadharya where Yushmat Shabda gives you some meaning, but there is a Lakshana done. Therefore it is a Ullekhya, Ullekhina, Ullekhini meaning. That when you put together and make a Karmadharya all the way across three words, then Tayoho Gocharayu cha Tayoho iti Vigraha Drashtavyaha Yadyapi Lakshanangikara Pakshe Yushmacha Asmacha Yushmad Asmadi Yushmad Asmadi cha Tau Pratyeucha Iti Vigraha Sadureva Tathapi Ullekhi Pada Vishishtatvena Vigraha Pratipadanam Vakyantarabhi Prayena Iti Vivekaha. So in one case Shashti is being done after the first two words, and in another case Karmadhara is being done. Both are Sadhu. So what I said is kechit tu deva iti. So this is how the alaukikatvam is there. Kechit tu deva iti buddhihi deva buddhir iti vatu yushmad asmadi iti pratyayu yushmad asmat pratyayu tayor gocharu iti bhashye vigraha iti vadanti. So you can add that iti vadanti. Tatra yushmad asmadi iti pratyayu ityanena yushmat pratyayu asmat pratyayu. Again typo here. Yushmat pratyasmat pratyayu iti prapte युष्मत् प्रत्यय इत्यस्य यूयम् इति प्रत्यय इति अर्थबोधकं वाक्यांतरम् अस्मत् प्रत्यय इत्यस्य वयम् इति प्रत्यय इति अर्थबोधकं वाक्यांतरम् इत्यभिप्रायेण यूयम् इति प्रत्यय युष्मत् प्रत्यय वयम् इति प्रत्यय अस्मत् प्रत्यय इति आख्यातम् इति आहु. सो देयर ही इज गिविंग डिफरेंट ओपिनियंस हाउ टू कंस्ट्रक्ट द समास बट द मीनिंग इज दैट देयर इज एन अलौकिक अर्थ लौकिक भिन्न अलौकिक अर्थ to both words here. This much is the takeaway from this because there are too many typos there and it's a little hair splitting as to what is the samasa, but this is going to come up as to what is the virodha. We have to focus on what is the virodha, so that virodha will be mentioned there. Shabda vigraha ityartha. Shabda means vigraha here, vigraha vakya. Vigraha pratipaditartha vishayatvam ityartha. So what is the meaning of this vigraha after you understand the vigraha, what is revealed? When, what is the idea of making such vigraha vakyas? Finally, what is conveyed? What is conveyed is the vishaya. Vishayatvam ityartha. What is the vishaya? And if once the vishaya is known, then you can know whether the yushmat vishaya and asmat vishaya. Yushmat pratyagochara vishaya and asmat pratyagochara vishaya. Is there virodha in them? That should be looked at. So, vishishta चेतन एव युष्मत् शब्द प्रयोग दृश्यते. सो विशिष्ट चेतने एव. ओनली इन दि विशिष्ट चेतना देयर इज अ युष्मत् प्रयोग. इट इज नॉट ओनली इन दि विशेषण. विशेषण इज नॉट कॉल्ड एज युष्मत् विच आई ऑलरेडी एक्सप्लेन. व्हेन आई से यू और व्हेन आई से दैट देन आई मीन विद दि चेतन अधिष्ठान. देयरफॉर विशिष्ट चेतने एव युष्मत् शब्द प्रयोग दृश्यते त्वं गच्छ आगच्छ इति. Again, typo here. Whatever sambhavat. Achetana ahankaradau kevale tara sambhavat. Ityartha sadhutvam vivrunoti nahit. So this nahi, that is going to come up again. You cannot, deal with ahankara as yushmat. Because Chetana is included there. Similarly with Asmat also, Anatma is included. Although you mean Chetana, Anatma is included. So this is what we saw. Idam Upalakshanam. Vayam iti Upalakshana means it is going to extend to the other also. Asmat also. Asmat Pratyaya Gocharam. Idam Upalakshanam. Vayam iti Pratyaya Vishayatvam Atmanyapi Nasti iti Drashtavyam. So you have to extend it as to when you say Vayam, this kind of pratyaya, laukika vigraha, will not apply to atma only. It will, you cannot say vayam atma. Vayam iti pratyaya is not related to the atma. In that vayam, the anatma should be taken away. The bahutvam also should be taken away. You should land on one atma. But the intention here is chetana versus achetana. In yushmat, achetana is intended, but chetana is also there. Since Chetana is there but not intended, therefore from Laukika, Alaukika is being landed on by Lakshana. Similarly, when you say Asmat, your intention is not both but only Chetana, therefore by Lakshana you are landing, you are giving up the Achetana, therefore it is Alaukika compared to the Laukika, which is a mixture on both sides. So, tathacha ubhayatra vishetvam nasti iti shankitur abhiprayaha ahankara vishishta chetane bhasamanatva rupam प्रत्यय विषयत्व मुख्यम केवल अहंकारादौ गौणम तथा च अहंकारादौ भासमानत्व रूप मुख्य विषयत्वा भावेपि भासमानत्व रूप गौण विषयत्वम आदाय साधुत्वमस्ति इति परिहरति. हियर आल्सो देयर इज अ टाइपो. परिहति परिहरति न च न गोचरौ इति. सो न गोचर पदस्य इत्यादि. सो व्हाट इज बीइंग सेड ओवरऑल इज दैट इट इज नॉट द वे यू अंडरस्टैंड. Therefore, sadhutvam is brought in the vigraha vakya, although there is plurality, by saying that we have to take away the laukika meaning of yushmat as along with chetana, but hold on to only achetana, and in asmat also the laukika meaning is chetana with the visheshana ahankara adi visheshana, that should be dropped, so you land on alaukika meaning, and therefore bahutva and sadhutva of the meaning both will be retained. This is the intention of yushmat asmat pratyegochare. We will see more in the next part. Stop here. यमिह कारुणिकं शरणं गतोऽप्यरि सहोदराप महत्पदं तमहं हरिं परमाश्रये जनकजाङ्गमनन्त सुखाकृतिं. Already late. If there are any questions, please ask me later. Namaste.